Summer. Okay, Ash, thank you. Well, whether it's summertime or any other time of the year for that matter, it's important to keep an eye on your skin. Here's News 8's Lisa Carberg with more.
Skin cancer awareness is important year-round, and here to discuss the challenges and treatments of skin cancer is Dr. Dean George, a cutaneous melanoma specialist at the Hartford Healthcare Melanoma and Skin Cancer Institute. Doctor, welcome.
Thanks, Lisa. It's great to be here.
Great to have you. So there are several kinds of skin cancer, but why is melanoma such a concern?
It's a good question. Well, melanoma is less common than basal or squamous cell carcinoma. It's dangerous because it's much more likely to spread to other parts of the body if it's not caught and treated early.
Okay, what should people be looking for?
Well, the most important warning sign of melanoma is a new spot on the skin or a spot that's changing in size, shape, or color. I like to share the ABCDE rule with my patients and provide this handy tool from the American Academy of Dermatology during our visits. A is for asymmetry, where one half of the spot is unlike the other half. B is for border, where the spot has an irregular, scalloped, or poorly defined border. C is for color, where the spot has varying colors from one area to the next. Shades of tan, brown, black, or even red, white, or blue can be seen. D is for diameter, anything bigger than a pencil eraser or roughly 6 millimeters in size. And E is for evolving, where the spot is changing in size, shape, or color.
Excellent. I love the way you spelled it out and showed us. So is melanoma preventable and how?
Well, there's no sure way to prevent melanoma. Some risk factors, such as your age, race, and family history, can't be controlled. But there are things you can do that could lower your risk of getting melanoma and other skin cancers. Limit your exposure to ultraviolet rays, wear UV protective clothing and sunglasses, apply broad spectrum SPF 30 or greater sunscreen to any exposed skin, and avoid tanning beds and sun lamps. Children need special attention since they tend to spend more time outdoors and can burn more easily. Parents and other caregivers should protect children from excess sun exposure by seeking shade and using the steps I've mentioned.
Excellent advice. I know I preach that to my 13-year-old daughter. All right, Doctor, what kinds of treatments are available at the Hartford Healthcare Melanoma and Skin Cancer Center?
Well, we treat local, regional, and metastatic melanoma in addition to cutaneous lymphoma and other skin cancers. We sequence metastatic tumors and routinely use the latest immunotherapies and signal transduction inhibitors in addition to other treatments. We have an innovations unit for testing the latest medications. Our clinical trials come through our alliance with Memorial Sloan Kettering Cancer Center and also directly from the manufacturers. We have an association with the Jackson Laboratory for Translational Research, and we're developing methods to turn immunologically cold tumors hot so that immunotherapy is more effective. Many new therapeutics were presented at the recent ASCO meeting, and we're excited to integrate anti-LAG-3 antibody into our regimens. Our center also treats ocular melanoma, and we have skilled interventional radiologists to support intratumoral treatments. Most importantly, we offer rapid access for patients with suspicious lesions. So please, if you notice any new spots on your skin, spots that are different from others, or spots that are changing, itching, or bleeding, make an appointment to see a board-certified dermatologist as soon as possible.
And doctor, quick last question. What if someone can't get into a dermatologist, or they're just, it takes long or it takes months? Can their general practitioner give them a scan and look at them? It's important to be looked at every year, correct?
A general practitioner is capable of scanning skin, and usually we'll get a lot of referrals from them, especially for suspicious lesions. And we have a nurse navigator within our program that has priority access for referrals from primary care physicians.
All right. Excellent advice. Thank you so much, Dr. Dean George. We appreciate this important advice.
Thank you for having me. Be well.